In this lecture, we will talk about defect, root cause, and its effect. This topic is marked as K2. So at the end of this lecture, you shall be in a position to differentiate what is root cause and what is its effect. So let's begin by defining root cause. It is the earliest action or condition that contributes to creating the defects. This means that when you find a defect, you also have to find the first condition that causes that defect. And we will understand this with the help of an example. Suppose this is the requirement. Once the speed is more than 115 km per hour, red light shall glow. So here, the speed needs to be more than 115 km per hour. After getting this feature, the customer is unhappy because customer checked this device and made the observation that there is a defect. Why? Because when he sets the speed to 116, he expected the red light to be on, but he found that it's still off. Now, to figure out why is this failure here, we have to do a root cause analysis. So here we are in the testing stage, but we have to go back a step to the implementation stage or coding stage. Here, we find that there is a condition that was implemented incorrectly. And the condition is if speed is equal to or greater than 150. However, our job is not done yet. Remember, we have to find the earliest condition. This means we have to go one stage back again. And the next stage is requirement and design stage. And in this stage, we found that some of the developers have written this system requirement. Red light shall glow when speed is more than 150. So instead of 115, they wrote 150. And because of this, the implementation was done incorrectly. And we found the defect in the coding stage. However, our job is not done yet, since we have to find the earliest condition. And when we investigated more, it was found that since the communication was verbal, this problem occurred. Now comes the point which you need to understand. Now, your job is to identify effect, failure, fault, and root cause out of these statements. So, customer is unhappy is a effect, and observation made by the customer is a failure. These two statements are defect, and all these problems occur due to the miscommunication. So, this is the root cause. So, we don't stop at this point. Now, we need to find the solution to avoid such problem. So, now we have to look for the action, and the action is any further communication will be done via email. So this is how you have to find out which one of these statements are failure, effect, fault, or root cause. We will see one more example to illustrate what we learned about defect and root cause analysis. And here is the life cycle of defect root cause analysis. This life cycle starts with a customer complaint, which is also the effect. Why is he complaining? Because he has come across a failure. He has received incorrect interest payment calculation. So the customer is trying to calculate his interest but received an incorrect result. And this was a failure. When we analyze this failure, we find that it was caused by a single line of incorrect code. When we further investigate this defect, we find out that wrong code was written because of the product owner's misunderstanding of how to calculate interest. This was the root cause of the defect that made the customer complain. So, we have this information. The product owner did not know how to calculate interest. But we cannot stop here. We have an entire team. So, how is that product owner does not know how to do the interest calculation? So, what we have to do next is called action. We figure out what to do so this never happens again. We train the product owner in interest calculation. This way, they will not repeat this mistake again. So, you see how everything is connected. This is how root cause analysis works. It starts from the effect, that is the complaint, and ends with an action, that is our method to correct the root cause. Now we will have a look into why we need to do a root cause analysis. The first point is to prevent a significant number of future defects from being introduced. We want to make sure that new defects don't crop up in the future. The second point is to reduce the occurrence of similar defect in the future. So, we don't want this interest calculation error to crop up again in our system. And the third point is to improve our process.